Matt Jones and Jimmy Smith from the Statesman Sports Network for the Statesman Insider 2009 preview, the last day of scrimmage today, a non-contact scrimmage, but they ran full plays. Coaches had the headsets. The offensive defensive coordinator sitting behind us getting everything running. A non-eventful day in terms of those who came out, but this is probably the most important scrimmage, getting those plays and getting those situations dealt with.
Well, Jimmy, this time of year, the last scrimmage is always the situational scrimmage, the scrimmage where coach puts them through the difficult situations, the things that players have to know in certain key games, bad snaps, bad punts, things along those lines. And these are the type of scrimmage that they go through those plays to get ready for next week.
We'll hit the road in 5 days. We'll be playing in 1 week, Texas A&M Kingsville, a 13-and-a-half-hour drive. And looking forward to it? You're looking forward to it? I know that you get your own seat, room.
That's correct.
Yeah.
Well, you know,
not so much for us.
There's a hierarchy.
I understand that.
It's completely joking. Not my own room. Do get my own seat for obvious reasons. But nonetheless, we're excited about it. We're used to this type of travel in the Gulf South Conference, and unfortunately can't find teams that want to come into Cleveland to play earlier in the year. So we've got to hit the road. Coach Ron Roberts is not afraid to play anyone, anywhere, anytime. And Texas A&M Kingsville said, let's dance. So Coach Roberts said, get your music ready.
We're dancing. 8 of the last 11 years we've opened on the road. This is no different and nothing new to the guys out here to our right. Talking to that GSC, preseason number one, the players did not let it get to their heads. A lot of great practices. They recognized the number one. They weren't picked number one the last 2 years when they won it. They're looking to repeat for the third time. It's called a three-peat.
Well, that's correct. And talking with Coach Roberts, he will tell you the only poll he cares about being number one in is the one at the end of the year. And the States in the last couple of years have kind of left something on the field. He's kind of tabbed this year as unfinished business. We've got 17 returning starters back, 47 lettermen off of last year's 10-2 team. And they have won back-to-back Gulf South Conference championships. And to take nothing away from that, Coach Ron Roberts will tell you the one thing that they want is that big championship trophy at the end of the year.
20-4 over his last 2 years, obviously averaging 10 wins per season. Expecting another 10-win season, but I'll tell you what, looking at the schedules, you can see it right now on your screen, the two big ones are the two obvious ones, North Alabama and Valdosta State. Both of those, luckily, the GSC recognizes huge games, and both of those will be on regional television on GSC TV. So you can even watch it here, or you can, of course, listen to us on the radio on the Statesman Sports Network.
Well, Jimmy, looking at the schedule, if the Statesmen do win 10 games, obviously we'll have to run the table. Only a 10-game regular season schedule this year. And looking at it, there's some trap games in there. It's not just the North Alabama and the Valdosta State game. We're talking about a vastly improved Arkansas-Monticello team from over just the other side of the river. And then Arkansas Tech is another team this year that has garnered some national attention in some of the polls, and a team that is going to be much improved this year under Coach Steve Mullen. So there's some dangerous games along the way for the Statesmen that if you just look at the North Alabama and the Valdosta State game, somewhere along the way you'll stub your toe. And as Coach Roberts gets these guys ready out here, it's one game at a time, one play at a time, 1 minute at a time, and we'll take it one game at a time.
A lot of these scrimmages have been position battles. Again, to our right here, there are a lot of position battles being dealt with. The punter, the kicker positions are still up in the air. One position that is nailed down and has been since the end of last year, quarterback Garrett DeWitt. 28 touchdowns last year, averaged 270-plus yards in the air per game. 63% of his passes were completed. He is going to have to, based on how the offense is run, have another great year if the Statesmen are going to run the table.
Well, again, Delta State's offense is predicated on timing. It's predicated on getting the ball out quickly. And one thing that Garrett does a very good job of is doing those two things. One thing that Coach Hicks and Coach Roberts will tell you is that he's got to cut down on his mistakes, his turnovers. 16 interceptions last year. Got to get those numbers down. Garrett will tell you that too. But he is a guy that does not mind a battle, does not mind to be pushed a little bit. We've had a tussle for the number two quarterback spot here in practice pretty much throughout the fall, and right now Mark Schlorp is in the lead where that's concerned. But Garrett DeWitt, clearly the starter for this football team, has been for the last 2 years, and excited to see what he will be bringing to the table this year as a senior.
The receiver position, obviously no true running backs for the Statesmen, a bunch of receivers. The obvious guys to name, Trevar Deed will be a guy to watch all season. Damon Carroll is another guy to watch out for. Todd Bradford from Auburn, the transfer. Rafael Mitchell's had a really good so far of the preseason. Those are some guys to look out for. Eldridge King is another guy. A lot of talent on that wide receiver core, and a lot of guys that are going to get a lot of touches this season.
Well, it pretty much starts and stops because of the timing of this offense. You're going to see 8-9 guys. You get a lot of snaps out there at the receiver position. You mentioned some of one guy you didn't mention was Xavier Rambo. Xavier, a transfer from Kansas, the University of Kansas. He has had a tremendous fall camp. And you mentioned Eldred King, another young man that transferred from Middle Tennessee State. They bring some added depth to the position that we do return some talent. Raphael Mitchell, a sophomore last year, had a great end of the season. Took him a little while to get on track throughout the course of the year. Everyone knows what Trevar Deed can do. He had his biggest games in the biggest games last year for Delta State. And again, he's a young man that we're expecting some phenomenal things out of over the next 2 years of his career. And there's some depth there. You mentioned Todd Bradford. We call him Pops around here, an older transfer. 6'4", 200-pounder that really can get up and down the field. A Chad Schroeder type for fans of Delta State football over the last couple of years, but on a much bigger body. So we're looking forward to that. And then another position that doesn't get as much hype because they don't get the ball quite as much, but is tremendously important to this offense, is a super back position. Derek Freeman, who broke his leg last year, could not play. He's the front runner right now. But a name to watch out for, and only because I like to say it, Klaus Geyer, 6'6", 256-pound junior transfer from Austria. He'll be a number two in there. He's a guy that can get up and down the field, but on that frame, you're not going to miss him in the backfield either. So it's going to be exciting, and it's going to be a good time. And then the offensive line, Jimmy, tremendously talented. Some big boys up front, average 6'4", 318 pounds, and you've seen what they can do in the fall.
Oh, absolutely. Guys like Pete Vasau are guys that are going to anchor this offense. Obviously, as a center, he's going to anchor the offensive line. They're fast. They look big and imposing. They are. But, two, they're very quick based on how the offense is run. A lot of screens, a lot of jobs for them to do outside of that line of scrimmage, running downfield after screens, things like that. A lot of speed for everybody on that line. Brad Latham, another guy that we've talked to over the preseason. Those are guys to look out for that you may not necessarily read about in the paper or hear about during the game.
We haven't really touched on the defense too much yet, Jimmy, and obviously want to talk about the defense, considering defense has kind of been what has gotten us where we have gone the last few years. Coach Roberts, head coach here, also the defensive coordinator, tremendous amount of talent on that side of the football. A lot of transfers in on the defensive line. L.J. Falagalli, a transfer from New Mexico military, will be joined by Vernon Saffold from right up the road in Clarksdale, Cahoma County, Cahoma Community College, Matt Melton, a junior returner, and then a guy that we've had a lot of fun with here in the fall camp anyway, Justin Rags. Yeah. Justin from right down the road in Moorhead has made the switch over from offensive line to defensive line. He'll be playing nose guard. He is a very imposing young man and will be a run stopper for us there. So the defensive line much improved, but the defense built around the linebacking core, the speed that's there, and it all starts and stops with Lardester Hicks Green.
Absolutely. Also, All-American preseason player to watch for, all GSC, all world, Lardester Hicks Green, and we'll follow him for the rest of the season. Let's set the table for the upcoming week as we'll be departing on Thursday. Here's the upcoming events to hit. Obviously, Monday night is the Coach Ron Roberts Show or DSU Live there at the warehouse. So come on out, have some great food, enjoy a great atmosphere, but more importantly, talk to Coach Roberts. Matt and I will be there answering your questions along with Coach Roberts, JT Webb as well, from the Statesman Sports Network. We'll talk about the upcoming season with Coach Roberts. We'll address those issues. You can ask him questions, but more importantly, come on out and support the Statesman on Monday night.
Again, we're looking forward to that. It's going to be a great event. It has the last several years, and Coach Roberts likes to be out a part of the media, get out, see the fans, get a chance to talk to the community. And again, that'll be Monday night at 6:30. We'll do our annual Pick'em contest like we do each year, have a chance to win some big prizes at the end of the year. First week, not many games to pick from, so we'll have only a sparse handful for you to pick this week, but I hope you come out for that. And then don't forget, many of the coaching staff, some of the players also will be there, so looking forward to you joining us for that event as well. So, Jimmy, exciting week coming up. Going to be a long week of travel, but a good week as the Statesmen kick it off for the 2009 season.
That's right. The Javelina is 7 o'clock on Saturday. Tune on into the Statesmen Sports Network to hear all the call. For Matt Jones, I'm Jimmy Smith. Thanks for watching. We'll catch you on Saturday, maybe Monday, maybe both, here on the Statesmen Sports Network and the Statesmen Insider.